Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
All right, welcome back from that break in case you're just joining us. You're still watching Game On, and we're still looking at the legacy of one of the greatest basketball players of all time. That is Kobe Bryant, who yesterday night perished in a sad helicopter accident. But quickly, we can take some of those calls. The numbers should be scrolling at the bottom of your screen. There you go. So if you've got any feedback, regarding Kobe, his legacy, what you think he added to the game of basketball, and precisely the kind of void that he leaves behind, head down to our phone lines. The number is scrolling at the bottom of your screen, and you can certainly feel free and give us that call. But for now, the conversation continues in studio. I've got Sharon on the show, certainly Vinny Jirua, a former, actually still plays basketball right now. And he's giving us his insights, and definitely Charles Mutebi from the New Vision. He's also a basketball player as well. The numbers are 0414-337-872. So those are the numbers. You can give us that call. But for now, the conversation does continue. Vinny, you give us some interesting insights while we were off air. Tell us about the influence that Kobe has had on you as a basketball chap.
Actually, you should put it very clear that he doesn't. He told us here he no longer follows NBA.
He doesn't watch games
ever
anymore.
Ever since Kobe retired. You should tell us why.
I stopped watching NBA when Kobe retired. It hurt me. The injury he got, the Achilles, was a season-ending injury. It really hurt me, but I'm like, he has 2 months to go, he's going to get back. Then he retired, it really hit me so bad. one of the reasons I do not really
so
watch
So even LeBron
NBA.
Hasn't brought you back
so
to Lakers.
So you mean LeBron is not even doing anything closer to Kobe Bryant at all?
In the past, we used to have this debate with a couple of my friends, Sudi, Marco Pio, or Toko Marquette.
Yeah.
We used to argue about who's better between Kobe and LeBron. But LeBron idealized Kobe, so it was really not a conversation to have. So it was crazy. But talking about my love for Kobe inspired me in a lot of ways. He helped me as a man. Kobe, one of the Mamba mentality traits was, in your worst moment, you still have to keep pushing.
Yes.
So as a man, we always have problems as human beings. Mm. But inspiration from such people really pushed me. Kobe really pushed me so much.
Okay.
So this is
the man is emotional. But Charles, in the early 2000s, Kobe was accused of sexual assault, a case that went quite on and had to be settled out of court. But beyond that, you know, he's been quite the family man. He's nurtured the daughter Gianna. She has been probably earmarked to play in the WNBA in the years to come.
Wow.
How much of an influence has he had around basketball?
Well, of course, the incident of sexual assault was resolved later amicably. He did come full circle. He owned up to the incident, and he said, in different terms, I'm paraphrasing, you know, this is something that I shouldn't have done. Initially, he denied it, but eventually, you know, with the passage of time, he admitted that is something that he regrets. And obviously, it was sorted out of court, and life went on. And ever since then, obviously, he has done so much to rebuild his reputation on and off court. And obviously, he has been seen in his last years as a very committed family man. He has been there for his parents and his wife. He actually, it was a very testing period because he almost lost his family. You know, the wife almost left him during that period, but the two were reunited. And many have rightly observed that he was looking forward to the second half of his life. He had also won an Oscar for best short film, you know, for some basketball short film he did about his retirement, the decision to retire.
The animation, their basketball.
Sure. So, and he had been diversifying into many things. Of course, now he was mentoring his daughter to take over his legacy as a basketball player. So, he has lived his life. I mean, he played at the highest level, won all that you can ask for as a basketball player.
Mm.
He had a family. Obviously, he wouldn't have loved to leave them the way that he left them.
Mm.
But on the other hand, he made the most of the abilities that he was given. As Vinny was saying, he worked hard,
yeah,
and, you know, gave it his all. So you can't ask for more. When you're given an opportunity, you make the most of it. And I think he did that. So.
Sharon, he came from a basketball playing family. His dad as well was an NBA player. His cousin played the sport of basketball. Not so many kids came up and had the opportunities that he had. But certainly he left such a big impact. Is there anything that the youngsters can take away from his legacy?
Yes, very much. Because like we said, we are celebrating a life of a living legend, much as he's gone. But normally, everything you do in life, you know that you're always creating an impact in people. I know there's so many idols and so many people out there who would want to be like Kobe Bryant. But it goes back to your family. Because if sports is flowing in your family, like for his case, born in a basketball family, raised in a basketball family, and then also born, gave birth to a basketball player. So I think even the project that he had started together with his daughter is going to move on and is going to create a legacy and probably encourage so many young people outstairs all over the world.
Yeah.
Because it was not about his basketball in the US or in the other part of the world, but even us in Africa, even us in Uganda here, like you've seen so many tweets from the Flavio Kechos, really ideally, it clearly tells you that it's something great that people are going to follow up from him. And how I wish to one day, one time, maybe we could do something in memory of Kobe, maybe have a stadium built in his name. To pay tribute to him and keep the legacy moving.
All right, the number is 0414-337-872. So in case you want to give us that call and tell us what you think of the passing of the legend Kobe Bryant, you can certainly give us that call right about now. But quickly, Vinny, certainly the conversation continues. And at some point, he's a guy that hit 81 points in a single game way back in 2006. And you're thinking these are phenomenal numbers. Do you have any single memory that just stands out about Kobe?
Actually, I have about three memories. You've spoken about one. That was against the Toronto Raptors. Scoring 81. Under normal circumstances, that is a team score. It's a high score. When a team scores 81 points, it's a high scoring game.
Yeah.
But Kobe scored 81. I mean, one person. And he never finished the whole of the game. NBA game is comprised of about 48 minutes. So he played about 41 and scored 81 points.
Wow.
It's one of the highlights. The only guy who has beaten from the 81 is Will Chamberlain, scored 100. So that's one of my memories. Then the second memory is Charles talked about Celtics. The Celtics fans hated Kobe like so much. And they hated Kobe like all tweets, even not Kobe related. There was a tweet, kill Kobe.
Kill Kobe.
But when he was retiring, he went to the Garden, that's the Celtics home. When he was waving to the crowd, some of them were in tears.
Oh dear.
It was crazy.
Yeah.
It was a source of banter. You know, sports without banter is also another. It's so boring. I mean, you need to have that banter to keep the fans under tension. So I think also at Celtic, every time the Lakers would be playing, all would be looking up to is how are we going to handle this gentleman? Not even handling Lakers as a team, but handling Kobe. So he was, how would I even term him? I mean, he was like a devil. You know how when Christians have gathered in a church and are praying against one human being like this. So Kobe was a devil for the Celtics,
the black
mamba for them, you know? So much there.
Okay. Finally, Vinny, any other memory?
The last memory I can say was, of course, again, what Charles talked about, the incident where he was accused of rape and was settled out of court, then going onto national TV and owning up to what you did and apologizing and crying in front of your wife.
All right, finally, as wrap up this conversation, Charles, you know, there's a legacy that stays behind. Where does basketball go from here?
I think that the good thing is that he had already served the game of basketball on court. So, and all his games have been captured on film, you know, like from day one to his retirement. You have all that information available. So he may have gone physically, but his memory, you know, will live long before NBA fans. And sometimes someone's legacy grows bigger in their passing than than when they were alive. So it will be interesting to see the reaction.
Hello, caller. Let's take some of those calls now. The numbers are scrolling at the bottom of your screen, and we want to speak about some of the memories you may have regarding Kobe Bryant. Hello. Good morning. Hello. Hello, good afternoon. Okay, 0414337872. Those are the four lines. You can feel free to give us that call right now. And certainly we're still talking Kobe Bryant and the legacy that he leaves behind. And if you've got any memories, you can certainly feel free and give us that call. The numbers are certainly scrolling at the bottom of your screens right there. So the conversation continues. Do you have any fond memories of Kobe Bryant and probably anything that he leaves you with in terms of memories? But guys, as we get to wrap it up, a minute each, I'll start with you, Sharon. As we wrap this conversation, anything that you want to leave us with?
About Kobe Bryant?
Yes.
We should just keep his dream alive and keep the legacy and keep building basketball to the world.
Vinny?
Yeah, to the basketball lovers and people who may want to play basketball in the future, please follow Kobe's mentality, the hard work, the determination, and the discipline. Yeah, that's what I can say about Kobe.
Finally, Charles?
Final words on Kobe? Yeah,
totally.
I think as Vinny said, emulate his ethic and learn from the best of his qualities. And celebrate your life. I love a saying that says, work as if you're going to live for. There's a saying that says, work as though you're going to live for 100 years and pray as though you're going to die tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so.
There you go.
Sure.
Thank you so much, Charles, Vinny. Sharon will continue the conversation as well. When we come back after the break, the FIFA Secretary General, Ms. Fatma Samura, is in the country. We'll be discussing that, including the under-17 girls through to the second qualifying round of the FIFA Under-17 World Cup qualifiers. And then also later on, Vipers have got a new head coach, the Ghana Cranes goalkeeping coach, that is Fred Kajobas. That and so much more after the break.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game on is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.